Shibbity wibbity, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my first Real Talk episode. This has been a series I've been interested in doing for some time now, but never knew what footage to really use or what to really cover, and if you can read the title, I decided on introversion. The footage is not really important, really, as it's just me goofing around and training, but this topic is one I have experience with, being introverted and having a best friend and girlfriend who are also introverted, so I feel like this would be an easy topic for me to discuss for those who have never even heard of it or wanted, you know, first-hand detailed experiences with it rather than some, like, textbook explanation. First off, if you've never heard the term before, basically an introverted person is someone who recharges by being alone, and I mean that, like, in the mental sense, because being out and about and in groups, an introverted person kind of gets, like, drained or exhausted by being in groups, where as an extroverted person recharges, like, where one person might be the type who, like, they're just very lonely until they go out and get to do something with a bunch of people. An introvert might see that as a very relaxing period. They need to recharge and, you know, be rejuvenated. And it's a very black and white scenario on the differences between the two personalities, but that's how the world's made up of three different types of people. There's extrovert, there's introvert, and then there's a mixture of the two. But the world is mainly dominated by extroverted people, without a doubt. So it's often a misconception that if you're introverted, there's something wrong with you, something that can't be changed, or something that can be changed or cured. But the reality of it is, there's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing to change. There's nothing to cure. Would you try and cure someone who, like, enjoys reading if you don't enjoy reading? It's in essence the same thing. So, like, one of the many misconceptions of introverts is that they're quiet, they're shy, or rude, or they don't have a lot of friends, and I can say for the most part, that's untrue. For instance, myself and many other introverts are quiet because of small talk, which is an extrovert trait. That's what they do. They don't like silence. They like to have small talk with people. And introverts are just kind of drained by that because they need something stimulating, something they're passionate about that they want to discuss. And if they don't have that, it's just a very mentally exhausting, you know, thing to them. And that can kind of go hand in hand with shy and rude, because an extroverted person might see that as, like, okay, well, this person's not very chatty or rude, that they didn't really try and talk back. And I think that's where the misconception comes from. It's easily understood if you don't understand that there's two types of people in the world like that. But these are, again, our personal traits that differ from person to person in no way directly affiliated with being introvert. And I'm talking about being, like, rude and shy and stuff. Like, an introvert can be very friendly and very outgoing, or they can be shy and they can be rude. It's just that's a personal trait. That doesn't really have anything that directly reflects on an introvert. A good example of an introvert versus an extrovert is my old neighbor and I. Like, he's the type who every single weekend he was having crowds of people over, drinking and having a good time, and I've even gone a few times. Like, initially I'm very excited to be there too, like I'm laughing, I'm having fun, really kicking everyone's ass in video games, of course. but that like wears off for me almost suddenly after an extended period of time. Like, I feel exhausted and I need a break. Like, it's not a a moment of panic, it's a feeling of just being exhausted. Like, I just need to be alone in my own space to recharge my batteries. But on the flip side of that, you know, where I would go home and now watch a movie or write or something, for him that was energizing. He was often seeking out chances to have parties and get people together, because that's what his mental energy craves. That's like what it needs to fuel that. And, you know, for the people that are like that, that's great. But that's one of the things I wish would change about the world, though, is because he's one of those people, because he's so much of an extrovert, he can't understand what an introvert is. And that's one of the things introverts can do, is they know what they are, and if, like, they've looked it up and researched and, you know, they have an understanding of it, they understand how an extrovert can feel, because introverts are a little bit of extrovert. Like, they do enjoy going out and having fun and stuff, but it's just not for as long. And an extrovert just can't understand that, because they don't really like to be alone. Like, that's a very lonely feeling for them. And introverts get lonely too, in the same sense. Like, if we're alone too much with ourselves, it doesn't really mix well. Like, you can get lonely and you need to go out and you crave a little bit of attention, but again, it's just the time that we need is a lot less than what an extrovert needs. And I wish more people would begin to understand some of this, because I feel like I've met a lot of, and I don't mean any disrespect by this to anyone, but I think me and a lot of other introverts have met some ignorant people on this subject, as in they don't understand, and I don't think they choose, they either can't or they don't want to understand it, because it just doesn't make sense then. There's something wrong with you, because that's, you know, they have their own way of living life and energizing themselves, and you're completely different. So that's where all the misconceptions come in, because it's an extrovert dominated world, and because of it, there's a lot of misunderstanding and a lot of misconceptions. And that's just one thing I really hope that through this commentary and through more research and more awareness, people will begin to understand that there's, like I said, there's ultimately three kinds of people, but it you boil it down, it's pretty much two. There's, you know, extroverted dominated people and introverted dominated people. So I really hope if you've ever felt this way, like if me explaining this, you said, yeah, well, I felt like that and I've never heard it, I'm going to put some links down in the description and I urge you to check it out. And if you've never felt like this, or you know someone who's felt like this, still, I think you should research a little more. And I'll, like, again, there'll be links in the description to check out. And there's a lot more to this than this, but I just wanted to cover the basic understanding of it. And if people want more information and a longer commentary, I'll do my best to get that out, but we'll cross that bridge if we get there. But I hope you enjoyed the commentary. I'm gonna try to cut this short, because I have gone over a little what I intended to. So if you liked it, make sure to leave it a like and check the description, read up on it more. It's a very interesting thing that a lot of people don't know about, and hopefully it gets more attention that it deserves. So, shibbity-wibbity, guys, I'll see you on the next video. Thank you for watching.